So that has come from this, the Family Story Bible, as told by Ralph Minton. Some of the children in the church already have one of these at home, and I am going to encourage you to find yourself a copy, if you would. In the bulletin and in passages, you have seen an article regarding this very Bible. This is a Bible that I would like to take us on a little journey through the summer with. I would like to start in 2 weeks, and then every single day, you would be given an assignment of one story. Just follow it chronologically through this Bible, one story a day. And each week you'll receive, either by picking up or finding online, a little questionnaire, some questions to ask as you go along. Now, why would I do this? Well, friends, let's be honest. There are two ways right now, general ways of thinking about God and the Bible especially. Have you heard, and you may be one of these people, and I don't want to step on your toes, but it is not in general what we, how we feel about the Bible around these parts. Have you heard of creationism? Creationism is in opposition to evolutionary science. And so for a certain number of people, a large number of people, Christians, creationism suggests that the world is 6,000 years old, and everything that has happened on this earth has been at that time. So, I would like to say, and in fact, did you know that there is a creationism museum? There is a creationism museum in Kentucky. And at that creationism museum, you can go and spend, actually, they'll sell you a ticket for $30 for every adult. It's a 2-day pass if you can spend time there. And in that museum, and you know, I don't want to make it sound so silly or anything, because it is very serious business for a great number of Christians, that to assert this idea that the world is 6,000 years old, and that things such as dinosaurs have existed in that time frame, okay? And so they go about trying, or at least speaking to the people who go there, asserting that and affirming that belief. So I, however, am not of that belief whatsoever. I embrace science, I embrace evolution. I also embrace the idea that the world is not 6,000 years old, that it is billions of years old. I nonetheless still believe in God, still believe that God is the maker and the creator of all things. And I know that there is a long spectrum of understanding between that and science. And there are scientists who scoff at creationists, there are scientists who scoff at anyone religious, there are people who are religious that scoff at science. It goes back and forth. And we can see this being played out in many ways. In not specifically biblical terms, but also in political terms in our society today. We are scoffing at one another. We are presenting our views, our understandings, our beliefs, our cherished understandings, even within parties. And we are shaking our fists at each other. And I believe that that speaking to the Bible, at least being in conversation of the Bible, can help us understand one another much better, can open up a discussion, whether it be religious, spiritual, political, personal, emotional, psychological, can open up all kinds of avenues and paths to for us to understand one each other and ourselves more clearly. And I would like to invite you then to be able to be a part of a discussion and to learn more yourself, because I'll bet a lot of you have said, oh, I'm going to open up that Bible someday, read it from cover to cover, right? I'm sure all of us have said that one time or another. Well, I'm giving you a chance. You're not going to hit every single topic, but you're going to hit the many themes. And well, the greatest theme that Ralph Minton speaks of is God's way. It's not our way, but God's way. And this is a very difficult, actually, thing to understand. What is God's way? And it's important to do that, because as I was speaking about the creationism museum, it's important, like I said, it's important business. Do you also know that they're now building a replica of Noah's Ark there? Yeah. did you know that this project is going to be cost around $90 million? That they have actually taken in approximately $18 million in contributions, and a local area has actually sold $60 million in bonds, unsecured bonds, to make this happen. So you can see this is very serious. So we cannot take this kind of conversation, this kind of thing, to is silly or is a one-off. It's an important thing that we begin to understand and know for ourselves, well, where do I stand on this? And I think that if we would be in a conversation, and at times that perhaps we will even scoff at one another's ideas, we will be maybe even assured by one another's ideas, but it will be a conversation. And so I invite you heartily to be a part of it. This Bible is, there's a sign-up sheet. There are about 12 of you who have signed up so far. I would love to have the whole church involved in it. And you can either get a hold of this on your own or tell me to order it, and I'm going to order it right away so that we can try to get as many copies as we can. And for you to be a part of this discussion, let me be maybe a little bit caustic. This is a quote, and this is how I feel in regards to this idea between science and creationism, or evolution and creationism, the versus, the whole opposition that exists here. There's a very famous scholar, his name is Dominic Crossan, and he has written a great number of commentaries about how we see the Bible, and how oftentimes we get caught up in the literalism that each and every one of us can find when reading the Bible. We all are, at some point, we draw a line in the sand where we say, this I can believe up to here, and this is what I really believe, but everything else, I'm not so sure about. But we sort of draw a line. And he said a very interesting quote. Now, I hope I don't step on your toes, but I probably will. But it's an interesting understanding, I believe, of how the Bible is represented more so in our frame of mind. Meaning Congregationalism, the United Church of Christ. Here is what he says. He says, in a discussion, he was saying, my point is not that those ancient people told literal stories and we are now smart enough to take them symbolically, but they told them symbolically, and we are now dumb enough to take them literally. Now that can be a very stinging indictment, and very, that's how, but in general, he spoke very stingingly. He used that word dumb. I would like to soften that a great deal and like to suggest that we need to consider the fact that despite the fact that we might disagree, calling somebody dumb is a pretty harsh thing. And we hear it a lot. We're hearing it a lot in our political discourse. I hope that we, by understanding our Bible, this foundational understanding of the world, these stories that actually get told time and time again in our lifetimes, told again and again, not only in our churches, but also in our social lives, these stories that hearken to who we are as human beings and how we act and how we're trying to understand the great, awesome greatness of the world and also the very intimate relationships that we share with one another. The Bible tells these stories. And if we base our understanding here and our understanding of the world and ourselves and God and our chosen teacher, Jesus, we can grow stronger together. We can draw not only our church and our community together, we can not only open our doors to more people, but we can also strengthen our nation and our world. We need to know how we feel first and do so in a loving, caring, and intentional way. So friends, I pray that you can do so. Jerry had something to say.
Hello to all.
most certainly. And I think that is something, you know, in many ways that people think is an inalienable right, is that freedom of speech in many ways, and understanding. So, and I would dare say that each of us is involved through our lifetime of our understanding of faith, of God, of social awareness, of who we are and who other people are. So I pray that you can be a part of this. Sign up. And if you need to peek in instead halfway through, that's fine also. You will never be shut out. You will always be a part of that conversation. Yes, Anne. Yes. And we tell stories to this very, very day. So Anne was speaking about the fact that Bible is history. So I pray that you can be a part of this. And if we center our understanding and our discussion around Jesus and his words of compassion, his words of understanding, his words of caring and love, even in the midst of great struggle, even in the midst of great hatred, it will be a way that we will grow stronger. It will be a way that we can lead in a world that needs compassionate leadership on all sides, from all places. I am not even going to get into the second story, but I do invite you that in 2 weeks is the celebration of the birth of the church, Pentecost. So in 2 weeks, wear red. Wear some red. That's a big thing to do in 2 weeks at Pentecost. So friends, as we tell stories, as we speak from our heart, I pray that each and every one of us can be at peace, not only with ourselves and our God, but with one another. Amen. May the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray.